In the fight against climate change, we have three tools. First, we should reduce emissions by using less energy, or by switching the type of energy we do use. Second, when we can't stop making CO2, maybe we can avoid releasing it by blocking it at the source. That's where technologies like carbon capture and storage come in. But what about the CO2 we can't block? And what about the CO2 already up there? That's where the third tool comes in, carbon dioxide removal, or CDR. One major approach you're going to hear a lot about is something called direct air capture, or DAC. DAC works by drawing in the air around us, removing the CO2, then sending the CO2 to storage. So, why is it such a big deal? For one, experts agree that we can't meet our climate goals without carbon removal, like DAC. Second, we'll need a lot of DAC. We mean a lot. So chances are it may show up in your community sooner or later. Given this massive scale, how can we deploy DAC responsibly? Well, because DAC is so energy intensive, it probably makes sense to place it near sources of renewable energy and heat, like geothermal. And to reduce transport infrastructure, we can place it where storage is. Areas with both might make good candidates for social and environmental impact assessments, to be followed by robust community engagement to talk through the risks and benefits. The good news is, this field is so nascent, we have an opportunity to do this right from the start. To learn more about DAC and how it affects your community, go to ceclab.cs.upenn.edu.